Sing on the album, and we decided to bring them on the road because they were so fabulous. So this next song from the album is a song about Elvis Presley, and Bernie went down to Tupelo, Mississippi, and sat on the front porch of the house that he was born in, and the song is called Porch Swing in Tupelo.
Swinging to blow in of the South, where the sweet honey drips out of the hush your mouth. It's the sun rolled on down that old natural street to Alabama cotton fields to the steel away. Time.
Shape our songs, and over the years we've always loved real great country music, and Bernie and I have written a few country songs on our old albums. On Tumbleweed there was Country Comfort, Dixie Lily on Caribou. This is a song which will probably be our next single, and it's called Turn the Lights Out When You Leave.
Gonna be
And there was a period in my life, for about 16 years on and off, where I took a lot of drugs and I took a lot of booze into my body. And I had some great times, but at the end of the day, you know, you can only do it for so long. And I just wondered at that time why I could never find a stable relationship in my life. And, you know, you just can't do that when there are drugs involved. And then I got clean, and then someone walked into my life when I least expected it, and became the title of this next song. And it's called My Illusion Drug. And we've been together now for 12 years, and we're as happy as anything in the world. So there you go. This is the daily. I'm not the same as I used to be. All the things you've heard seem hard to believe. I haven't always been good. I've never really been bad. This next song is about a sex change. And, It's called They Call Her the Cat.
All right.
Perfect. My room number is... Anyway, this is called Freaks in Love. me and you could be our curse. We've got green and heart and flower. You got strength, but you got no curse. We're just free to love.
No matter you say. like a dog. My desire never wound up on top. I can see now how little of the moon is out of reach, somewhere beyond the sea. I always hope that I'll do better.
This week, and we've reissued it in a special edition with a live recording done at Wembley Stadium in 1975. It was recorded at the Caribou Ranch in Colorado, and it was written on the last voyage of the SS France from Southampton to New York. Well, my part it was written, Bernie wrote the lyrics beforehand, but I wrote it on the boat, and it was the first album and the only album we've ever written that was about us two. For those of you who are not familiar with the album, it tells the story of when we were struggling as writers to get recognition, to get any songs covered. And it really covers our life up to our very first album, which was called Empty Sky. And during rehearsals, which we've been doing this week here at the Orpheum Theatre, I've been revisiting some of these songs that haven't played for 30 years. And it's a deeply personal album, and it brought back many memories. I'm not a nostalgic person. I like to look forward and not look back. But it brought a huge smile onto my face, and it realized how special my relationship with Bernie is, was, and still is, you know, after 38 years. It kind of changed our lives. The album came in at number one. It was the first album ever to come in at number one on the Billboard chart. And as characters, he became the Brando Cowboy. He lives in California and raises bulls and cutting horses. And I became Captain Fantastic. Running around the world, owning my soccer team, meeting the best people, playing with the best artists, living my life as the dream I had when I was a child. So we're going to do some songs from the album right now. And I hope you enjoy them just as much as we've done rehearsing them this week. Here we go.
Thank you.
Bitter Fingers.
Thank you.
Okay, this is called Tell Me When the Whistle Blows.
Bottom of the road, down the road.
went down a lot, you really should have been there. Sinner like a princess perched in her electric chair. It's one more beat, and I don't believe anymore.
Thank you.
ticket. Each other like brothers, and these songs say how it was then and how it is now, and it's called We'll Fall in Love Sometimes and Curtains. Wise men say it looks like rain today. Crack on the speakers and trickle down the sleepy subway trains. The heavy arms can hardly hold up, aching legs that often told us it's all worth it.
wise men say, it looks like rain today, it crackled down the streets, it trickled down the steep itself away. Oh,
and I'm spent with my treason.
Time, let's fight. be a long, long time. I think it's gonna be a long, long time. Oh. Thank you.
last March I was in the recording studio in Los Angeles waiting to do a duet with Ray Charles for an album called Genius Loves Company. And we all knew that Ray was not in the best of health. But when he came to the studio, we were all really shocked to see how frail he was. And we just sat in two armchairs side by side and sang this next song through. And it was one of the greatest professional moments of my life, because ever since I was a kid, I idolized this man, the way he sang, the way he played, the way he had so much soul. And for me to be singing in the studio with him, and for him to be singing one of my songs, was one of the greatest moments of my professional career. And it was also one of the saddest days of my life, because it was the last session that Ray ever did, and it was tough. But I have great memories, and I want to dedicate this song to some friends of mine here tonight, David and Mario, to Mr. and Mrs. Robert Kraft, who've been amazing friends to me. Go Patriots. Go, go. All right. You go Patriots. Come on. And the fabulous Sydney Bullen can read. This is the song called Sorry Seems to Be the Hardest Word.
Oh,
Tim Curry. Latanya Shield. Rosalind McKnight. And Denise Sim. And the boys, Todd Honeycutt. Charles Bullock. On the big bass voice, Terrence Davis. Adam Chester. And another Adam, a choir leader and vocal arranger, Adam McKnight. And now for the boys. First of all, percussion and vocals, Mr. John Mahon. On keyboard and percussion, our own keyboard and orchestral wizard. Keyboard and percussion, yeah, well, there you go. Guy Babylon. Bass guitar, vocals, and pickled onions, Mr. Bob Birch. And one of the original members of the three-piece, Elton John Band, along with the late, great Dee Murray on bass and guitar and vocals. Still playing as well and singing as well as ever, Nigel Olson. On guitar and vocals and mandolin, Mr. David Johnston.
Rolling Stone.
Jesus. Double life's the name, and send him to the final school in town. I'm not afraid. truth seem to fade to black and white. Save myself from falling. So generous, as you always have been throughout the 36 years of coming here. It's always a pleasure to come to this area. I love it here. I want to thank you for all the loyalty and love you've shown me over all the years. Thank you, God bless. This is for you. It's a little bit funny. This feeling inside, I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no, a man who makes potions and a traveling show. Nothing not much, but it's the best I can do. I give it to my song, and this one's for you. This is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that I'm done, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put you down in the world. How wonderful life is when you're in the world. All that got me quite proud, but the thunder been quite kind. Well, I wrote that song. It's for people like you that keep me turned on. So excuse me for getting but these things I do. I forgot the green of blue. Anyway, the things what I do. Because I just realized
How wonderful life is. Well, you're the one.